this. Good evening, everyone. We are assembled here this evening, the last day of May, Pentecost Sunday, to witness the miracle of the marriage covenant that God is about to make. The Bible teaches us that marriage is to be between one man, one woman, freely, totally given to each other as companions for life. So with all that being said, who gives this bride in marriage? Ben, would you step forward, receive your bride, come back this way, please. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. And I say, Lord, before everyone present and before all of heaven, how honored I am to be here with Pastor Ken, my dear brother, my friend, and his bride that is getting ready to be his soulmate and for the rest of their lives. Lord, I pray that every word that we speak, every thought that we do, brings glory to Jesus Christ, O Lord, during this time. We love you, we give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. And we all say, Amen. Please listen as I read from the fifth chapter of Paul's letter to the church at Ephesus. Don't worry, I'm not going to read it all, Pastor Ken. I saw that worried look. But here's the deal, guys. You know, I love weddings because this is the only time that I can stand before two people, female, male. God created you both. Uniquely made, different emotional makeups, and only God and no one else can make two people that he has created one flesh. No piece of paper, although I know that the legal document in marriage is important, but no piece of paper and certainly no pastor, and not putting ink upon a page can make the two of you one. But what's getting ready to happen is that miracle where God makes two. With that being said, the Bible teaches us, Rita, it says, wives, submit yourselves unto your husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husband as unto the Lord. That word submit has caused a lot of problems in this world. But I want you to remember this, both of you. That word submit didn't come from men, because men have made that a bad word. And even some pastors have made that beautiful word submit a bad word. But that word came from God the Father, the one who created male, female, and marriage. And that word submit literally means this, mutual submission, because you both love the Lord. It's not about your will. It's about both of you wanting his will in your marriage. So with that in mind, Pastor Ken, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. I know you know that scripture by heart. Probably taught it as many times as I have, but it always amazes me that God commanded us to love our wives. And I know you love them because you're right here. You're loving because you're going to marry them. But God says that freedom has to be loved as you come in a special way. And the word love there is a verb. It's not just saying that you love her. It's demonstrating that love, which I know the with all of my heart that you give. So, husbands, love your wife, even as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water of the word, and that he might present it unto himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. And he that loveth his wife loves himself, for no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but he nourisheth and cherisheth even as the Lord the church. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and be joined unto his wife, and they two shall become one flesh. And Paul says, and this is a great mystery, and indeed it is. Ken, is it your confession before Almighty God, all the people that are present, that Jesus Christ is your Lord and personal Savior? And Frida, is it your confession before all that are present, that Jesus Christ is your Lord and personal Savior? That I make this charge to all that are present with us right now, that in the eyes of Almighty God, Jesus paid for their sins, my sin, your sins, right here on the cross. And every sin that we've ever committed, the Lamb of God has taken it away. Thank God for that. And they have prayed, and they believe with all of their heart that they are in the perfect will of God to marry, to be married. So from this moment on, I charge everyone that's listening to my voice that you do everything within your power to make sure that this marriage remains prosperous and holy and godly. And woe be to anyone who has ever tampered with this marriage. What God is about to join together, let no one ever put asunder. Ken, do you take Frida as your wife, as your own flesh, to love her even as Christ loves the church, to protect her and care for her for the rest of your life? Then turn to her now and make this profession of your love and faith. I, Ken, according to the word of God, leave my father and mother. I join myself to you, to be a husband to you. From this moment on, we shall be one. And Frida, do you take Ken as your husband, submitting yourself to him as unto the Lord, showing reverence to him as the head of this union for the rest of your life? Then turn to him and make this profession of your faith and love. I, Frida, according to the word of God, submit myself to you to be a wife. From this moment on, we shall be one. May I have Frida's ring, please? A ring is a precious thing. It's a precious metal. It's a never-ending circle, always indicating the never-ending love of God, the love that he has for you. I pray in Jesus' name that for all of your lives, that you wear these rings and never ever forget that it's God's grace, it's God's word, and it's God's power that sustains you and keeps you in all that you do. With all that being in mind, again, take this ring and place it on your finger, and as you do, say this to her. With this ring I do wed. It is a token of my love for you and my faith in Jesus Christ. Before Frida puts the ring upon your finger, I want to charge you with a memory, and then I'm going to charge you with a memory. I pray, beginning this day, for the rest of your lives, that you never, ever forget that this woman that God has given unto you. I know that you know all about spiritual authority, spiritual leadership, and I love you for that, because you're a good man, marrying a wonderful woman. But I pray, as you put this ring, as she does, upon your finger, that you remember that she is now your helper. And that word, as we both know, it means not someone who washes the dishes and all of those things. It means that now she completes you. That part that's been empty, the part that's been woman, the part that says, now I'm in love, completes you. So with that in mind, Rita, I pray that you always remember, and I know you know this, but there's absolutely no place in God's Word that ever gives anyone the right to dominate or control. It's that mutual love that you have for one another. So with all of that being said, your vows have stated that you submit to one another now and the responsibilities of this life, expecting God, His love, His Word to always make the difference. So place this ring upon His finger, and as you do, please say this unto Him. With this ring I thee wed. It is a token of my love for you and my faith in Jesus Christ. As a representative of Jesus Christ, before God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you one together, one blessed. You are now husband and wife, and you serve him as your bride. Let us pray. Father, I thank you in Jesus' name for Pastor Ken and Frieda, Lord. I thank you for their lives. I thank you, Lord, that you have made them one. I pray that you prosper them in every area of their lives. And Lord God, I pray for a beautiful, wonderful hedge of divine protection around them, that they prosper in your will. And that, Lord, I see that heart of the husband and the heart of the wife. Oh Lord, let their love just deepen and grow deeper over time. And we give you praise for that, Lord. We give you honor for that in the mighty name of Jesus. May I present unto you as we turn, Mr. and Mrs. Ken Davis. Amen. Let's thank the Lord.
I see it in your eyes. You can feel it from my heart. I'm here all after. Stay the way we are right now. And shed all the love and laughter a lifetime. You're the one.